Choo-choo! All aboard the hype train, calling at VPN station. What's that? What is a VPN? How to use a VPN? Why should I care? Good questions, internet user. Now come with me on a journey through time and space as I answer all your questions. Before we go any further, if you are interested in VPN news and reviews, don't forget to subscribe. Also, if you're thinking about getting a VPN, which since you are here, I guess you are, have a little look at the VPN discounts I got linked in the description below. All right, so here's the thing. Over the past few years, VPNs have gone from being a fringe piece of software only used by edge runners and computer peeps to daily necessity. But these days, everyone from Google coders through to your casual streamers are getting on the VPN bandwagon. However, with all the positive publicity, a lot of people find themselves confused, not sure whether they genuinely need one or if it's just pointless hype. Are VPNs now a necessary part of the world, or can we keep ignoring them for a few more years? These are the questions we need to answer. So stick around and let me answer the most classic VPN beginner questions. What is a VPN? What do they do exactly? Why do you need a VPN? And in such an oversaturated market, which VPN should I be looking at and which VPNs are good for beginners? Well, let's find out. Over the next few minutes, I'm going to give you all the vital info, and I'll give you a short breakdown of some of the best VPN names out there, giving you a nice starting point for VPN adventure. So, what is a VPN? A VPN, otherwise known as a virtual private network, is at its core a tool for privacy and security. VPN is that service that lets you connect to the internet through an intermediary server, while also encrypting your traffic that will ensure your online safety. And there are more ways how VPNs can be useful. So, what is a VPN used for? VPNs can be quite a few things. Let's talk about specifics. They help you access and watch geo-locked content. They help keep your data private. They help you connect and use public Wi-Fi securely. They help you bypass state-sponsored censorship, great for users in countries like China and Thailand. They're also great at getting around local network locks. So if a network admin at school or work locks a website, with a simple switch activating your VPN, you can access all the sites you like. They can even save you money while shopping. Similarly to when content is geo-locked, in a lot of online stores, prices vary depending on where you are, meaning someone in Russia will probably pay less for the same product that someone is in the US. Pretty cool, right? Okay, so now we know what VPNs can do, let's take a look at how to use them. First things first, you're going to want to sign up to a VPN of your choice. I'll go through my recommended list in a moment, but for this demonstration, I'll use one of my personal favorites, Surfshark. It's super simple to use and a great VPN for beginners. It's also very cheap, has a money-back guarantee, and a whole list of useful features. But I'll go through all of that in a second. Once you've gone through the sign-up process and paid, which on most VPNs can be done anonymously using cryptocurrency and an email address, it's just a simple case of downloading the software, starting it up, signing in, configuring a couple of settings, and picking a server location. Honestly, it couldn't be easier. And most of the reputable VPNs guide you through the process, reducing the chances of screwing up to plain old zero. After you've connected to a server, every site will think you're in that server's location. Easy. Once set up, you can surf the internet in peace, safe in the knowledge that you're protected and secure. And even things get dangerous, you're one switch away from terminating your connection. Now, at this point of the video, I gotta point out a key concern I always get people asking me. And so super necessary in a VPN tutorial for beginners, and that's whether a VPN is legal. To answer it in the simplest way possible, yes, VPNs are legal, at least in most countries. But you will be safer if you Google if that's the case for your country. Okay, by this point of the video, I expect you want to know what to look for when shopping for a VPN. So here's a list of the main features a VPN should have. First and foremost, look for a no-log policy. This simply means that the VPN won't log any of your actions. So even if the VPN is legally required to give info on their clients, they can't as they actually don't have any. Other key features include a kill switch that will sever your internet connection if your VPN drops, stealth protocols for getting around censorship, a good server list spanning across countries and continents so you can enjoy all that Netflix regional content. Also, don't forget to have a closer look at a VPN's customer service. Some of the best VPNs out there have a live customer support, meaning you can talk to a real person who will either guide you through your issue or remotely access your device and do it for you. Now, here's 7 VPNs I can can recommend as great places to start for both beginners and experts. They are, in no particular order, Surfshark, NordVPN, Private VPN, Viper VPN, Private Internet Access, IPVanish, and of course, ExpressVPN. All these VPNs offer great money-back guarantees, a full set of reliable features, have apps for Windows, Mac, Android, and iOS, are speedy and reliable, have reliable customer support, and most importantly, trustworthy and stable server lists. Okay then, so at the end of the day, VPNs are amazing, super easy to use tools which increase your security and privacy online. And on that beautiful note, I'm going to end this tutorial right here. Don't forget to check out the links in the description below for the best VPN deals and discounts on the market. Also, if you haven't already, please like the video and subscribe to the channel to keep up to date with all the latest VPN news and tutorials. Stay safe out there now, and see you next time.